Magic Man, Tennis Preacher, Prophet, Psychic, and Tennis Pastor. Don't forget that, Tennis Pastor. Coming back at you with another video. Okay, people, this is called a preview of the preview of the Dow and Federal. So you're saying, why am I calling it preview of the preview? Because the reason I'm calling it the preview of the preview is because the Dow hasn't won yet. He hasn't beat Chilich yet. And Federer hasn't beat Del Potro yet. So then you'll probably ask him, but then why don't you just wait until they beat him and then do the preview? No. The reason why I'm making this video, people, I want to tell you all what to look for. Because if Nadal and Federer meet, say by this time tomorrow, most people going to be afraid. I mean, people going to have who they want to win, but everybody's going to be scared to make predictions. Y'all know me, I'm bold. I'm going to make a prediction. But even experts, they're going to be scared. They're going to be afraid. Scared to death to make a prediction because they don't want to be wrong because it's going to be hard. But so let me tell y'all what to look for. Let me tell you all, if it's Nadal versus Federer, this is a good measurement right here. Okay, Nadal is playing Chilich and Federer is playing Del Potro. So now somebody could argue that Chilich is a better, slightly better player than Del Potro. But I would say, hey, right now, they're pretty well even. And both of them are U.S. Open champions. Both of them got one major. So both of them have at least operated under pressure. But I'm just saying right now, if you ask me who I'd rather play, you know what? Both of those guys are dangerous right now, sort of at the same level. So let's get back. This is what you want to look for. You want to look for, can Nadal beat can Nadal beat Chilich quicker and easier than Federer can beat Del Potro? For example, let's say Nadal beats Chilich straight sets, 6-3, 6-3. And then Federer barely beats Chilich in the third set tiebreaker, 9-7. Hey, man, you probably got, that means Nadal is playing probably at a high level. Now, you know, it ain't no problem. It does mean that. Now, somebody could say, well, possibly Federer could step in there Sunday morning and still get in there with Nadal and figure it out and step above Nadal and beat Nadal. Okay, that's true, too. So we have to consider that, too. But I'm just saying, this thing I'm saying about how bad Federer and Nadal beat their opponent versus in comparison to each other, that's not the total measurement, but that's a good measurement, and that means a lot. So just look for that. Look for how bad Federer beats his opponent versus how bad Nadal beats his opponent, and whoever beats their opponent the worst, that usually will probably mean that that player is playing at a higher level. And so that is one measurement that you can use when you're trying to decide, like everybody else going to be Sunday night saying, oh man, who's going to win this? Is Nadal going to win it? And Federer going to win it? And you're going to run all the history and that Federer beat Nadal 3 times this year, but Nadal has beat Federer more in the head-to-head. Just all kind of stuff going to go through you all's mind. But I'm just saying, just watch for that. That's a important thing, and that's the most recent thing. That's what makes this very important. That would be just a few hours old. How bad does Nadal beat his opponent in comparison to how bad does Federer beat his opponent? Okay, people, y'all know me, man. I try to tell it like it is. Magic Man, Tennis Preacher, Prophet, Psychic. You know the way I like to do it. Have a nice day.